guitar lesson for Dark Horse by George Harrison, of course, off the Dark Horse album. This was a special listener request, and the listener wanted the demo version by George, so I'm not 100% sure. It's been a while since I've listened to both, but I think the only difference really is the capo in the demo is on the fifth fret, which I'm doing on this lesson, and I think on the studio version, the capo is on the seventh fret. So I think if you want to play along to the record, Dark Horse, you got to slide the capo up. I forget which way George played it live in Japan, but the chords are all the same, the shapes are all the same. So I've kind of simplified this a little bit, and you know, this is my arrangement of Dark Horse. So if you want to call it the Dark Horse demo, I think it's a little slower and it's a full step lower on the key. So I'm going to call the chords with the capo on the fifth fret. And the song's pretty straightforward. You know, there's some funky stuff, and I'm not doing everything George is doing, but let me give you some basics on this and then just play it your own way. I'll break it up into three parts. I'm going to start with the intro, the verses, and the middle refrain, the Dark Horse part, and shouldn't take long. So the intro is just two chords. It's an A7th and an E7th. So that's the two chords, but on the A7th, you're going to want to hammer on... We want to hammer on the second string, so it's going to sound like this. So you want to get kind of that hammer on the second string, and then on the E7th, it's a little more involved. So at the E7th, I'm hammering on the third string first fret, and then I'm hitting the open E, and then the second string third fret. So the little riff that I'm kind of playing is. And I'm doing all that with the strum, so I'll try to do it slow. So sometimes I play it a little sloppy, and I'm not sure George's playing exactly that, but it's something like that. So that's the intro, again, A7th to E7th. Now we get into the verse, pretty similar. We're going to start with the A7th. You thought that you knew. And then it's back to the E7th with the same little riff. Back to A7th. Fooling you again. Same E7th with the riff. And now I'm going to go to a B7th. But with the capo, I have a hard time doing the whole thing, so I call this a lazy B7th, a three-finger B7. I'm just going to play the bottom four strings. I do this a lot. So I'm going to play a B7th. You thought that you had got me all stained out. Back to E7th with the riff. Back to the B7th. I've been breaking out. So I've simplified this a little bit, but just to make it easy, I'm just going to play an E. And then I think it's an E7th sus 4. So it's just an E. And then we're just going to go up. We're going to walk it up to the E7 sus 4 to an E7. That's part two, that's the verse, and if you want to do a little guitar tap, now the Dark Horse part, we're going to start with some bar chords, B flat, to an F, to a C, so, I'm a Dark Horse, then hold the C, but add the high G string, running on a dark G, race course, to a D, then repeat that, B flat, F, add the high G, running on the G to D. One more time. B flat, F to C. And hold the C, add the high G. Four souls. One more time. I'm a dark horse. Hold the C. And if you want a little tap, then bring it back into the intro. That's really it, folks. I mean, it repeats a lot, and George adds some funk to it. So this is definitely not everything that's going on the record, or even the demo, but I think it gives you a good foundation. Play it your own way. As always, that's my advice. Have fun with this. Great song to play and sing. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, and thank you for the request, a deep request for the George Harrison demo version of Dark Horse. Thank you. Take care. I'll see you soon.